How are you?
Hello.
Hi. Real great privilege to meet you. Thank you so much for hosting us here. It's a honor.
How are you doing?
Nope. I think they're in the car. How are you doing today? You campaigning?
Not today.
Not today? It's much warmer here than it is in Canada. Minus 30 when I left.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you say minus?
Minus 30.
Minus 30. You got there and lost that.
Yes. We'd love to have you visit Canada at some point in the future. But you're smart to be staying in Canada to work on your election.
When does the weather start to get warm?
The end of March, I believe.
Well, March is supposed to go up like a lamp in England, a different sort of weather condition.
Lion land, I think. Yes. So, amazing. It's good luck when you wear it. So you want to wear it on election, it's good luck. With the maple leaf on.
Oh, it's the maple leaf forever.
Yeah, exactly.
I know that. And I was trying to listen to questions. And that's my mother also in the kitchen in Boston.
Okay.
And that maybe with the color of the KMU, his decoration. Very nice young man.
Thank you.
Some years ago, the Canadian Parliament voted unanimously to recognize your great contribution to humanity and to the world, wonderful efforts here. And this doesn't happen very often. In fact, I'm told it's that you're only the fourth person ever. Unanimously doesn't happen very often, but you're the only the fourth person ever been accorded this honor. So on behalf of Prime Minister, I'm very pleased to be here.
You mean? Thank you, man.
As you know, Canada has very tough sanctions against your country right now, and you've spoken about that just recently. But should Canada be thinking about altering its regime in some way to allow for more space or more spending for development or capacity building, perhaps aid the Burmese people? Do you think there's any room for that right now? And Mr. Baird, you might want to weigh in on this as well when she's done, of course.
I think right now it's important that you all watch how the elections proceed. That's only 3 weeks anyway. We're not asking for a very long period. And we are very anxious for the elections to be free and fair, which means not just free and fair voting on the day of the election itself, but during these last weeks in the run-up to the elections. We have just discovered there are many, many irregularities on the voter list, and we have applied to the Elections Commission to do something about this. So I would like you to watch very closely what's happening to make sure that the elections are free and fair before you decide what the next step should be with regard to sanctions.
There's a lot of enthusiasm among Western countries right now apparently being expressed about some of the reforms. Is the government getting too much credit perhaps right now in the West for some of what's going on?
I don't think there's anything wrong with enthusiasm. Enthusiasm is all right, but I think you should also be very balanced in your judgment. An enthusiastically balanced judgment would be what you want.
Listen, I would be very thrilled to begin to lift Canadian sanctions against the current government here. But obviously, we want to watch very closely the next 3.5 weeks of the campaign. We're concerned, I was very concerned to learn about a good number of irregularities which the party is bringing forward to the government, to the Election Commission officials. We look forward to seeing the results of that. Very concerned to hear that though, but we'll obviously be watching on Election Day, and we'll be watching on the week, 2-3 weeks after Election Day to ensure that the results are fair, transparent, but also that those results are respected by the government.
Daw Aung San Suu Kyi, my name is Adrienne Arsenault. I'm with the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation. Some people have told us they're concerned that your credibility is being used, perhaps, to lend some legitimacy to a government that hasn't yet really earned it. To what degree does that prospect worry you?
It doesn't worry me too much, and provided you wait, as I said earlier, if you will wait and watch and you judge the cool head, where we are heading, then I think things would not go wrong. I would very much like our country to be helped, but of course I want to make sure that the help gets to the right people, and this is what you have to be careful about. We would welcome development aid that is used for our people, which means that the first requirement, or the first two requirements, are transparency and accountability. Unless there is transparency and unless there is accountability, I do not think you can take it for granted that the help that you give is going to benefit our people.
Minister Baird, if I may. Again, some people here and some Canadians I know who work here and live here have reached out to you to say they are concerned that Canada's great capacity to offer help in infrastructure and the creation of civil society and the building of that is not being used at a moment when perhaps the people in this country need it the most. So, yes, if the sanctions are applauded by some, but is there not an opportunity to ease up a little bit on some of the development aid, which to make sure it goes to the right people?
Well, listen, Canada first put in sanctions back in 1988. We toughened them in 1997 and 2003, and in recent years. We've got a big event coming up in 3.5 weeks. We're going to watch that very, very closely. We're going to see how when the dust settles, what the results were. I do believe on providing support to civil society, demonstrating the great advantages of federalism that we enjoy in Canada. There's a substantial amount of support that I think we can provide that I think would be welcome. But we'll be looking at that in the weeks ahead. We would love to do that. We would love to offer additional development assistance. We'd love to begin to lift the sanctions, but only when we see an expression of the demonstration of the power of the ballot box, which will be happening on April 1st. So we'll be watching. But on the support for civil society and democratization, there's a lot that Canada can do. I think there's been no argument, I think, from either of us.
Well, of course, I would very much like our people to be helped. But I think the first step must be taken by the government of the country itself. The government of this country must do its best to help its people first. It's no use saying, why aren't other countries helping, until we can prove that our government is doing its best to help our people first.
The Canadian government has completely stopped since 1988. So now after the series of the changes and reform here, so can you tell me when will you restart and resume the ODA program?
Well, we have provided, we still are providing assistance through international agencies like the UN. We are providing not unsubstantial support for refugees or displaced persons on or around the border in parts of the country. We would love to be able to play a bigger role in development and a bigger role in trade and commerce, and we're very keen to do that. We have had these sanctions in place since 1988, and they can be we can begin to lift them and begin to provide more support very soon. But we are going to watch very closely the way the officials deal with the allegations of irregularities, which are of great concern, ensuring that there's a fair and open, transparent vote on April the 1st, and then in the days and weeks after that, that vote is recognized and respected. And then I think we'd be very keen to do that.
Thank you.
I'm from Radio Australia, and the question I would like to ask is that President Benson is apparently very keen to ensure that the elections are free and fair, and it seems that we have been hearing news that there's been a lot of negotiations and shortages in the campaign, in the NLD campaign. So what I would like to say is that countries like Canada and countries like Australia, what else can they do so that those messages filter down?
Well, first of all, are you asking me or are you asking the minister?
I think both.
Well, you would answer first as to what you think.
Listen, I mean, I think Canada will work with our like-minded allies. We have Australia as one of our closest allies. The United Kingdom, the EU, the United States. I think we will all be collectively watching together the election results. We'll be watching how allegations of electoral irregularities are dealt with before the election and on election day. I think that there's a keen desire on all of our part to play a bigger role in the future of the country in supporting change. But we're going to hold our judgment for a few weeks until we do that. There is a great deal of discussion among foreign ministers from all those countries I mentioned, excited about the prospects for reform. We've come a long way. We couldn't present this in person, this honorary citizenship, just a few short years ago. April 1st will be a very important day. And I think you'll see a good deal of enthusiasm to work together to provide support to the people of Burma.
In the meantime, I think we would appreciate it very much if the world were to closely watch how the Elections Commission responds to the complaints that we that are put up to them, because they need to act, and quickly. After all, we only have 3.5 weeks left.
Thank you.
Sue Ahern, Radio Australia. What sort of action are you hoping for?
Well, for example, with regard to the irregularities in the voters list, they have to put those right. A lot of dead people seem to be prepared to vote on the 1st of April, and we can't have that, can we? And other things like that.
My question is, if the election is not free and fair, what will happen?
Me or are you asking the minister?
Both.
Well, we'll certainly complain loud and long, and we'll make sure that whatever has gone wrong is put right at some time or the other. We always have to work towards redress of some kind. We don't want to condemn irregularities outright if they can be remedied in some way.
Listen, I'll be very honest. I had a very good meeting with the president earlier. My counterpart, the Minister of Foreign Affairs, and with the Speaker of the Lower House, and I'm excited by their enthusiasm and support for a free, fair, and transparent process. And there's nothing more than I would like than to put out a statement on April the 2nd, congratulating them for such a clean, transparent, and fair
not
election.
Sure, all the results will be in by the 2nd of April. I'm not sure we work that quickly.
In Canada, we get it done that night.
We're not Canada.
But if you know, once the election results are in, we're very keen to hope for the best that they are fair, transparent, and open. Some concerns have been raised. We think they need to be looked into and responded to one way or another.
Yes.
And. But let's not plan for the worst of case. But obviously, the world is going to be watching on April the 1st. There is a lot of interest in every corner of the earth. There's a lot of excitement about these reforms coming to fruition. And there's no better way than those reforms to come to fruition than a free election.
For Lukemia, we still don't have the freedom of press. We are still under the censorship. So for us, it is very difficult to report the ground even like a frog, you know. So it is still difficult for us to rapport the real situation.
Well, I've had to submit my television statement for censorship, so I'm afraid I agree with what you say that we do not yet have complete freedom of information, we do not have complete freedom of communication, but this is what we'll have to work towards, and this is one of the reasons why we are contesting this election, that we will have a chance to work for this, towards such freedom of the press, of information and so on, from within the National Assembly, as well as from without, because we've been carrying on extra-parliamentary politics for more than 20 years, and now we're expanding our activities into Parliament, we hope.
Has any progress been made on international election monitors? International election monitors, has any progress been made on that issue?
Well, I understand that the President told some members of ASEAN that perhaps it might allow ASEAN countries to monitor the elections on the day of the elections itself. But in my opinion, it's more important to monitor what happens during the run-up period, because I am fairly confident that the election day itself will not go too badly.
We were blocked, and I believe you were too, by the police on the road to the rally. Do you have any concerns about what happened?
Well, we don't quite know why that road was blocked off. We were told that this is because they were practicing for the 27th of March, which is what we call Resistance Day and what the Army calls Army Day. And it just meant that we had to take the long way around. We did get to a rally. We were a bit late, but it didn't matter because the people were prepared to wait.
Josu, this is a bit embarrassing, but as Canadian to Canadian, I wonder if I may boldly ask for 3.5 minutes of your time after alone.
3.5 minutes. Do you have a stopwatch?
Yeah, I can.
Okay, I think 3.5 minutes will be fine. Thank you very much. And my media religiously married.
Yeah. You're welcome.